saving refuge for one he has anointed. Save your people, Lord, and bless your heritage given them forever. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Grace and peace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And with your spirit.
Good evening to all of you.
Good evening, Father.
Let us pause for a moment. Thank the Lord for the gracious life that he has extended. We place our needs, our intentions, our sinfulness, our sicknesses, our brokenness, the stress and strain that we undergo, the bondages that we still hold on to. We thank the Lord for the families who have come to thanks and Jude, especially for the blessings and favors they have received. We thank the gift of the married life of George and Demia as they are celebrating their wedding anniversary today. We place our dearly departed ones, and especially praying for one of our closest families, mother passed away. May she rest in peace. I confess to Almighty God and you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and my words, and what I've done, what I failed to do. Through my most great fault, therefore I ask this Mary, your
Holy Angel of Saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God.
And may Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ,
have mercy. Lord, have mercy. Let us pray. Grant, O Lord, that we may always revere and love your holy name, for you never deprive of your guidance those you set firm on the foundation of your love. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen.
Please be seated for the first reading.
Reading from Book of Kings. Sennacherib, the king of Assyria, sent messengers to Hezekiah, saying, "Tell this to Hezekiah, king of Judah. Do not let your God, whom you are relying, deceive you, when he says, 'Jerusalem shall not fall into the power of the king of Assyria.' You have learned by now what the king of Assyria have done to every country, putting them all under the ban you are likely to spare it." Hezekiah took the letter from the hands of the messenger and read it. He then went up to the temple of the Lord and spread it out before the Lord. Hezekiah said this prayer in the presence of the Lord: "Lord of hosts, God of Israel, enthroned on the cherubs, you alone are God of all kingdoms of the earth. You have made heaven and earth. Give ear, Lord, and listen. Open your eyes, Lord, and see. Hear the words of Sennacherib, who has sent to insult the living God. It is true, Lord, the king of Assyria have exterminated all the nations. They have thrown their gods on the fire, for these were not gods, but the work of men's hands, wood and stone, and hence they have destroyed them. But now, Lord your God, save us from his hand. I pray you, let all the kingdoms of the earth know that you alone are God, Lord. Then I saw, son of Amos, said Hezekiah, Hezekiah, "The Lord, the God of Israel, he said this, I have heard the prayer of your address to me about Sennacherib, the king of Assyria. Here is the oracles that the Lord has pronounced against him. She despises you. She scorns you, the virgin daughters of Zion. She tosses her head behind you, the daughter of Jerusalem. Remnant shall go out from Jerusalem, the Savior from Mount Zion. The jealous love of the Lord host shall accomplish this. This then is what the Lord says about King of Assyria. He will not enter this city. He will let fly no arrow against it, confront it with no shield, throw up no earthwork against it. But the road that he came on will return. He shall not enter the city. It is the Lord who speaks. I'll protect this city and save it for my own sake, for the sake of my servant David. That same night, the angel of the Lord went out and struck down 185,000 men in the Assyrian camp, and Samaria struck the camp and left and returned home and stayed in Nineveh. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Responsorial Psalm. God upholds his city forever.
God upholds his city forever.
The Lord is great and worthy to be praised in the city of our God. His holy mountain rises in beauty, the joy of all the earth.
God upholds his city forever.
Mount Zion, true pole of the earth, the great king's city, God, in the midst of its citadels, has shown himself its stronghold.
God upholds his city forever.
O God, we ponder your love within your temple. Your praise, O God, like your name, reaches to the end of the earth.
God upholds his city forever.
Please stand for the gospel acclamation.
Enter by the narrow gate, since the road that leads to perdition is wide and spacious, and many may take it. But it is a narrow gate and a hard road that leads to life, and only a few find it. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Please be seated. I read recently a caption, and it is written like this: take the Lord seriously. Take the Lord's sayings seriously. Take the Lord's actions seriously. Today's verse reading reminds us about the mighty, pride, arrogant king Sennacherib challenging the prophet, the prophets of the people of Israel. He is misleading the people. And this is what is being said. Sennacherib sent his message to his messengers, making the people of Israel to fall away from or drift away from the original and true God. And this is what he says. The messenger is Sennacherib, goes to King Hezekiah of Israel, tells like this: tell this to Hezekiah, the king of Judah. This is more important. Do not let your God on whom you are relying deceive you. When he says, Jerusalem shall not fall into the power of the king of Assyria. And you have learned by now what the kings of Assyria have done to every country, putting them all under the ban. And you are likely to be spared. And there is a reason why I use the word arrogant king Sennacherib. He says, never ever think the Lord whom you uphold. You know the response of the psalmist, the Lord upholds his city forever. In other words, Sennacherib is telling, do not put your trust in the God whom you rely. The history has shown the Assyrian king has defeated many kingdoms, and Judah will be under the power of the Assyrian kingdom or king. You know, sometimes, not sometimes, always there is a saying, pride hath a fall, isn't it? And God knows what is best. God knows how to humble the people. He has put down the proud and exalted the lowly. This is what our Mother Mary will sing. He has put down the proud and he will exalt the lowly. Give ye your Lord. So therefore, now Hezekiah is praying to God. He knows his inability. He has humbled himself before God, the God of Hezekiah, the Judean God, God of Abraham and Isaac and Jacob. He prays like this: O God, give ear, give ear, O Lord, and listen. Open your eyes, O Lord, and see, and hear the words of Sennacherib, who is challenging you. You remember the story of 450 priests of Baal challenging one prophet of God, which we have been always, had been referring for the last couple of days. God listened to the challenge of Sennacherib, the king of Assyria. Do something. The Lord upholds his city forever. The challenge of Sennacherib is this, that your God is not going to protect your temple. You know, Jerusalem temple is the greatest for the people Israel. And the Lord is not going to protect. The Assyrians will come and defeat you. God will answer the prayers. when we put our trust in Him. Very often we think God is not able to hear our prayers. Don't think God will answer to our prayers. God is interested in our prayers, and God will answer to our prayers. And this is how the Lord has answered the prayer of Hezekiah. That same night, the angel of the Lord went out and struck down. Did he hear how many thousand? 185,000 men in the Assyrian camp. Now sometimes we should know the Lord will fight for us. You have heard the Bible, isn't it? If we trust in the Lord will fight for us. If we trust in the Lord will break our bondages. The Lord will remove our death, provided we need to trust. So, Hezekiah will tell the inability of him and his kingdom to the Lord whom he trusted, and the Lord sent his angel to fight, and 185,000 men in the Assyrian camp were killed. The Lord will uphold his city forever. You need to pray every day like this. Even if not too many prayers, Lord, put a fence around my family. Put a fence around my property. Put a fence around my children, that they may be free from every type of evil actions, immoralities, that they may be free from death, accidents, misfortunes. And when you pray like this, God will send whom? His angel. And each one of us has got a guardian angel. And each one of us will be protected by the mighty archangels. Angel Gabriel, Raphael, and Michael will come powerfully and will protect us. You know why? Because our trust is in the name of the Lord who made heaven and earth. When a bishop comes and during the Mass he will say, "The Lord be with you and with your spirit. Our help is in the name of the Lord." And we say then, "Now and forever, who made heaven and earth." And our help should be this, in the name of the Lord who made heaven and earth. And Hezekiah believed in the power of the Lord. We need today to offer our resistance. Now as the coronavirus is spreading, those who are coming from KC Council, they will stop you soon coming to Frankston Council. But you pray every day, "Lord, please put a fence around us and protect us." That's what I have done here in this campus. Nobody will die of corona here. Because I know God will put a fence around. I know St. Mike will be there to pray. I know the Lord will uphold His church. I know the Lord will uphold the St. Jude's church. Because I am believing in a powerful God who is alive. Who is the God of Hezekiah. Who is the God of Jacob, Moses, and Joseph. And I believe in a God who will save each one of us from death. And I believe also in a God who has said, even if you bring deadly poison to the priest, the anointed one, even if you bring deadly poison, not for committing suicide, okay? Someone gives us poison, nothing is going to happen to us. And I strongly believe in such kind, such power of the Lord. And that power is that what we need to hold on. Parents, pray for your children, putting a fence around. And pray every day, "Lord, remove every stressful moments that we have." And people of Israel, people of Judah, they are so much of stressful moment every now and then. The Assyrians were coming and attacking them.
But they trusted in the providence of God. Our help is in the name of the Lord who made the heaven and earth. Amen. Almighty and merciful Father, may your power come upon each one of us as we stand before you. We pray for the Holy Mother Church, for Francis, cardinals, bishops and priests. Lord, put a fence around them. Protect your church, Lord, hear our prayer.
Lord,
we pray for all the families who are here, especially the family of Sheffer and George's family, as George and Remya celebrating their wedding anniversary. Lord, bless them completely. Transform them, Lord, hear our prayer.
Lord, hear our prayers.
Lord, in a special manner, we pray for Rosalyn, 72, whom we have been praying a week ago. And the Lord has given her eternal reward. May your powerful love come upon Rosalind and the family. Lord, hear our prayer.
Lord, hear our
please
prayer.
Feel free to make your own petitions.
Lord, I pray for the holy souls in purgatory, for those who are dying this day. Also pray for families. Lord, hear us.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Lord Jesus, we pray for all those who are suffering from anxiety and depression. And we pray for all those who have addictions of any sort, that you will touch and heal them. Lord, hear our prayers.
Lord, hear our prayer. Surrendering ourselves, our needs, intentions, and asking for the protection, not only for today, in the coming days and in the years. Let us submit all our prayers and petitions through the mighty and holy intercession of our Blessed Mother Mary. Hail Mary,
full of
grace, the Lord is with you. Blessed are thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen. Please be seated for the blessing.
Thank you.
And is there any others who are celebrating their wedding anniversary or something? My dear friends, you have come here with your family and friends to celebrate your faithfulness to each other and to thank God for the ease He has given to you to live in mutual love. Through the joys and sorrows, the triumphs and trials of life, God has been with you. The church shares the joy today and is thankful to you for being such a powerful sign of God's loyal and faithful love for the world. God has enriched and strengthened you over the years by the sacrament of marriage. In renewing your commitment today, you give witness once again to God's love. You have proven your devotion to each other by your life together. Now join your hands. Say loudly. Do you renew your promise to be true to each other in good times and in bad? To be true to each other in sickness and in health. To love and honor each other all the days of your lives. You have renewed your consent once again before the church. May the Lord's goodness fill you both with His blessing and harmony youth. So, 13 years of married life, let's give them a big hand. Join in the men, bow your heads, and please, every one of us will stand and bless them. Please stretch your hands. And then join your hands. My brothers and sisters, let us turn to God that He may extend His blessings upon these couples. Blessed are you, Lord, King of all creation. You have made us your beloved people. You have showered your gifts upon us. With these couples, we thank you for the years together. Continue to fill their hearts with the love for you and for each other. Stretch out your hands upon them and bless them. Grant that as they have lived their lives with one heart and one mind, may they continue to witness your presence in their marriage. Bless their children, Ivan and Guru, and all their family and friends. Lead them through this life to eternal happiness with you. We offer you all praise and glory through Jesus Christ, our Lord.
Amen.
Please stand. Pray, my brethren, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. Receive, O Lord, the sacrifice of conciliation and praise. Grant that cleansed by its action, we may make offering of a heart pleasing to you through Christ our Lord. The Lord be with you. Lift up your heart. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God. Through your beloved Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, the Word through whom you made the universe, whom you sent as your Savior and Redeemer, incarnate by the Holy Spirit and born of the Virgin Mary, fulfilling your will and gaining three holy people, stretched out his hands as he endured his passion, so as to break the bonds of death and manifest the resurrection, and served all the angels and saints, we declare your glory, as with one voice we acclaim, Holy,
Holy, Holy, Holy, Holy, Lord of hosts.
Heaven and earth are full of thy glory, Hosanna in the highest, blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord,
Hosanna in the highest.
Lord, you are holy indeed, the fount of all holiness. Make holy then for these gifts to be prayed by sending down the Spirit upon them like a dewfall, so that they and blood of your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread, giving thanks, broke the bread, gave to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, into the chalice, and once more giving thanks, gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, drink from it, the chalice of my blood, blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith. When we eat this bread and drink this cup, we proclaim your death, Lord. Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, Peter, Cummins, earlier Bishop, the Order of Bishops and all the clergy. Remember our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep, especially praying for Roslyn. And all those who are dying in your mercy. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, Blessed Joseph, her spouse, blessed apostles and glorious martyrs, St. Jude and Mary MacKillop, and all the saints who please to you throughout the ages, we may merit to be coerced eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ. Through him and with him and in him, O God Almighty, Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Amen.
Amen.
At the Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to say,
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. Lead us not into temptation,
deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin, safe from all distress, as we wait in joyful hope for the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom of power,
all the glory of God,
Lord Jesus Christ, you said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you." Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church. Graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
Peace of the Lord Jesus Christ be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer each other the sign of peace. May this mingling with the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ bring eternal life to us who receive it. Amen. Lamb of God,
you take away the sins of the world. Have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Grant us peace.
Lord Jesus Christ, Son of the living God, who by the will of the Father, the work of the Holy Spirit, who has brought life to the world. Free me by this your most holy body and blood from every evil. Keep me always faithful to your commandments. Never let me be parted from you. My dear friends, we are going to receive the Holy Communion together with those who are sacramentally receiving Jesus at this time. We pray together with them. My Lord Jesus, I believe that you are present in the most holy sacrament. I love you above all things and desire to receive you into my soul. Since I cannot at this moment receive you sacramentally, come and lay spiritually into my heart. I embrace you as if you are already there, unite myself wholly to you, and never permit me to be separated from you. I thank you, Jesus, my Lord and Savior. Immaculate Mary, pray and protect me under your mantle. Amen. Behold, this is Jesus Christ. Behold, the Lamb of God, broken for us. Happy are those who are called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am worthy to be under my roof.
May the body and blood of Christ bring eternal life to us who receive.
Amen.
Renewed and nourished by the sacred body and precious blood of your Son, we ask of your mercy, God, that what we celebrate with constant devotion may be our sure pledge of redemption through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
And may Almighty God bless you, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Let us go in the peace of Christ.
Thanks be to God.
Michael the Archangel, defend us in the hour of battle. May God rebuke you humbly, we pray, and do thou, O Prince of the Heavenly Host, by the power of God, cast into hell Satan and all the evil spirits who wander about the world, seeking to ruin his souls. Amen.
I see you.
Praise be every moment. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit. Bless and praise be every moment. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit. Bless and praise be every moment. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit. Let's all bow down and worship the Lord. The opening prayer. O St. Jude, holy apostle, faithful servant and friend of Jesus, you are honored and petitioned by the universal church as a patron of this church, populous and impossible cases. Pray for me, I'm so very helpless and I feel alone. Intercede for me that Almighty God will bring this day where it is needed most. Come to my assistance in my great time of need. Pray for me that I may be given the comfort and help of Jesus. Most importantly, I ask that you pray that I may one day join you with all the saints in heaven to praise God in consolation and rest in joy for all eternity. I will remember your praise as Holy Saint Jude. Our Lord is my patron, so many have before me. Because of the grace of God, deign to give freely at your request. Amen. Dearest in Jude, friend and apostle of Jesus Christ, and expert in despair and cases, hear my praise. In all my needs and desires, may I always see what is pleasing to God, and what is good for my salvation, and the salvation of the world. To you, to please beg God for help with all my requests. I submit my prayers to you with great confidence in your intercession. I know that you will pray fervently at the feet of God, and I will receive his greatest blessings. I know that our good and gracious Lord leaves no sincere prayer unanswered in some way. Help me to see his answers and praise him, even if they are not what I expect. Amen. St. Jude, Lord Jesus, Son of God, our Father,
who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name, thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven.
Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against
us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from all evil. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with you. Blessed are thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit. Please be seated, and in the silence of our hearts, let us adore the Lord. good.
All the time.
God is good.
God is good.
All the time.
And all the time.
God is good.
There are two ways in which we can glorify God. There are many ways, but three important ways. Number one, we can glorify God by our thoughts. Number two, by our words. And number three,
by
our deeds. So we can glorify God by our thoughts and words and deeds. And this is exactly what we pray during the confession to Almighty God. Through my words, through my deeds, and what?
My thoughts, words, and
thoughts, words, and deeds. Either our thoughts can be manifesting God, or it can be manifesting the devil. Our words can be the same. Either we can use our tongue to praise God and His name and give glory to His people, but we can also give glory to the evil one. Our action should be directly leading towards God. So avoid every bit of negative things, negative feelings. Stop reading things that will create us negativity. And negativity can lead people into negative actions. You know, some planned murder, some planned theft. Sometimes these are all the repercussions of watching such kind of things. And people entertain all that, entering into bad actions, because we're being fed with either bad thoughts or bad words. And it will lead into bad actions. So God wants to purify our words, so purify our thoughts, purify our words, and purify our actions. And if we are in that bondage, B-O-N-D-A-G-E, if we are in that bondage, there is someone who is there to help us. Through the powerful intercession of St. Jude, who is there to help us. And today is the sixth day of the prayer is that we pray to St. Jude, who knows our despairing cases. The stressful moments that have come due to words and thoughts and actions. The harm that is being done. I think it is right to place it before the Lord. The Lord will hear us. The Lord will answer to us. Because the Lord is our shepherd. Standing before the Lord, or kneeling before the Lord, let us place ourselves to Him who can purify our thoughts, our words, and our actions. Amen.
Amen.
Please kneel.
Bow before Thee, O Lord.
Grant in glory that we may celebrate the sacred mysteries of your body and blood, as always to be conscious of the fruit of your redemption. You who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
By our words, thoughts and actions, may we glorify you, Lord. Through our sickness and sufferings, may we praise you, O Lord. By breaking every bondages, we glorify you, God. Bless each one of us, our families, our bondages, our stressful moments, our death in the family. Bless our country, Australia, Victoria, especially southern part of this place, free from coronavirus. Protect our children, God. Lord, continue to strengthen the marriage bond of George and Remy as they are celebrating their wedding anniversary. Bless each one of us, Lord. And may the Trinitarian blessing be given to us at this very moment. May the Father, Son, and the Holy Spirit be glorified now and forever. Amen.
Amen.
Blessed be God.
Blessed be the Lord.
Blessed be His holy name.
Blessed be His holy name.
Blessed be His. Blessed be Jesus Christ, true God and true man.
Blessed be Jesus Christ, true God and true man.
Blessed be the name of Jesus.
Blessed be the name of Jesus.
Blessed be His most sacred heart.
Blessed be His most sacred heart.
Blessed be His most precious blood.
Blessed be His most precious blood.
Blessed be Jesus in the most holy sacrament of the altar.
Blessed be the
Holy Spirit, the Paraclete. Blessed be the great Mother of God, Mary most holy.
Blessed be
her holy and immaculate conception.
Blessed be
her glorious assumption.
Blessed be
the name of Mary, Virgin and Mother. Blessed be St. Joseph, her most chaste spouse. Blessed be God in His angels and in His saints.
Thank you.
stop the evening masses, not on Tuesdays, but other days he was planning to stop, but then because of the 50 numbers, but now again we are coming back to the same, so there will be masses every day evening at 6:30. Only on Tuesday we have the mass at 7 o'clock, otherwise every day we have the mass at 6:30 in the evening. For those who are coming for the evening mass, please make sure first to come first. You're free to come. But we have the morning mass that is for mainly for our local parishioners, elderly people, they can't come in the evening, can't drive and all that. But otherwise, those who are coming for the evening mass, you're free to come. But then we will keep that number around 20-22 people, will keep it in the church. Continue to pray and support for each other, but be free from corona, that's the way. But once you get, don't come.